Alright guys, what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna show you a bit of my world, a little bit of my world that's unique to me, because I mean the world is huge and I wanna see as much of it as I can. But there's little things to everyone that you know you won't see regardless if you travel or not, so I'm gonna show you something unique to me. I'm gonna show you my back garden, my backyard, because I think it's a little bit different to what most people have, and I'll just show you that, and maybe then you can show me something that you have that I won't see anywhere else. So let's set sail. Woo! Okay guys, here we are. This is Curragh Plains. This is my backyard. Welcome. It's basically a vast stretch of green grass, trees, fern bushes for miles and miles and miles. It's very nice actually. It's a very stark contrast to the opposite side of where I live, which is a very busy, industrial, commercial, packed and crowded town, which, you know, the same as everywhere else really. But you won't find this anywhere else, I guarantee you. It's the only place like it in the country. Has a lot of history behind it, I'm sure. It feels nice, really. I mean, it's here. For those of you into movies, you've all seen Braveheart, I take it. Of course, you've seen Braveheart. Freedom! Yes! Well, yeah, you know, that movie. The fight scene in that, the huge fight scene, that was filmed just behind me, way, way back there, in just a huge, huge open plain. Over this way, over here, what we have is the Irish Defence Forces' training centre, main and training centre camp HQ for the country. But naturally, I won't be going in there or showing you any of that. No, it's nice. What we have actually here beside me is Mana Graveyard, which is some really. I'm going to go in and just show you one or two things in there. It's really old. I don't think anyone's actually been buried there in years. It's nice. I'm going to show you. That's not nice, I mean, it's still a graveyard, but I mean, I'm going to show you one or two things inside there that I think are interesting. And after that, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to kind of walk around. I'm going to show you some other stuff. There's lots of little interesting things around here. And we're going to go on a walk. We're going to show you some of them and what I can find or what I've time to do even. So, yeah. Alright guys, so here we are inside the graveyard. I just wanted to show you one or two things. Behind me here and outside to me are military burial graves. I mean, I'll just read some of them out here. I mean, Royal Field Artillery, you've got Royal Engineers, you've got Rangers down there, Special Forces. I mean, and some of the burial dates on these, they're like, just looking at this one here, it's 29th of March 1917, age 21. I mean, it's a young age to die. I mean, 1917, it's almost 100 years ago now. It's Jay Mulligan. He was in the Royal Field Artillery, sergeant. I mean, I just wanted to show you some of these. I mean, and for something that's here nearly 100 years, they're in really, really good nick. I mean, I know it's a graveyard and, you know, you don't expect anything to happen to them, but remarkably good nick for where they are and how long they've been here, so. No, I just wanted to show you that. Let's go. As you walk around here, you'll see lots of little monuments like this one, just scattered throughout the place. They look different, I mean, they don't all look like this, but just the little things on them, it's Dan Donnelly, born in Dublin, 1770, died 1820. Well, let's see what it says on the other side. Erected by public subscription, 1868. So there you go. That one for it. So, as well as the other things you'll see around here all the time, the trees, the grass, the military personnel, you'll also see sheep. They're everywhere, but they're nice and cute and fluffy, and they run away when you chase them. Woo! This is what happens to sheep who don't listen. The sheep's jaw, or half of it, teeth and everything. Ugh. Right, I just got a quick glimpse, just to show you there. There is actually armed military personnel walking around here. I mean, it might be nice, but it's still a military HQ area, so gotta be on your toes. Okay, where I am now is inside one of the densely packed treed areas. There's no major forest here. What there would be is kind of lines and patches of really densely packed trees just around the place, because mostly it's just kind of green plains everywhere, so yeah, trees. What we have behind me here is a pillbox, or what I believe to be a pillbox. Clear that this was here from way back when in the war. This is a military area, so you can see the use for it here. Inside, it goes down fair deep. There's a room for about maybe three or four people, plus guns, ammo, whatever else needs to be in there. It's fairly big inside, and it's common. There are a good few of these around the whole area, but I won't be going too far in there because I think they might take the camera off me, so let's move on out a bit. I'll show you some other scenery. So here I am, me and my log in my back garden, my yard. That is the Curragh Plains, Ireland. I hope you liked what I've shown you so far. I've shown you what I can show you. If you'd like to see any more, just let me know. I'll see what I can do, or better still, come visit. Ireland's a great place to come to, and you're all welcome. It's a nice sunny day. I'm having a great time. And I've shown you just a little bit of my world that I don't think you'd get to see otherwise. So that's why I'm doing this, in the hope that you will show me just some of your world, just a little thing. It doesn't matter what it is or where it is, just some place that I wouldn't get to see otherwise. That is out of the way, just a little bit different. That's it, it's you, it's your world. And I'd love to see that. So, you know, I hope you've enjoyed watching this. I've had fun doing it, and I look forward to seeing what you have to show me.